Hello and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to be doing a sketch of the Galaxy M51, also known as the Whirlpool Galaxy. But first, I'm going to quickly just show you my telescope, and then I'm going to run you through where this object is located in the night sky. And then I'm going to run you through the sketching process, and then I'm going to show you the final sketch once it's all said and done. So stay tuned for that. All right, so here's my telescope in all its glory. Got the dew shield on. And currently I have my High Point Scientific 32mm Plossel eyepiece in. And that's what I'm going to use to do this sketch, so stay tuned for that. M51, also known as the Whirlpool Galaxy, lies in the constellation Canes Venetici. Although it looks like it should be in the constellation of Ursa Major given its close proximity to the handle of the Big Dipper. M51 sits around 23 million light-years from Earth with a diameter of 73,000 light-years, and relatively bright in the eyepiece with an apparent magnitude of 8.4. This can be spotted with a pair of binoculars or a small telescope, but the details really start to show through with larger telescopes. M51 and the smaller galaxy NGC 5195 are interacting due to NGC 5195's possible pass through the core of M51, which is why they appear to be connected. Now that we've seen where M51 is in the sky, let's get on with the sketch. In this field of view, there weren't a lot of stars, so star placement didn't take too long. As usual for my sketches, I placed the stars using an HB pencil. I scanned the field of view looking around for any stars I may have missed, and then spent some time focusing on the galaxy, and keeping my viewing eye closed to get it as dark adapted as I can for seeing as much detail as possible. The arm connecting M51 and NGC 5195 seemed pretty bright along with the central cores of both galaxies. I smudged some 2B and 4B pencil off to the side of the sketch and rubbed the blending stump in it in order to place the galaxies. I find this helps quite a bit with not applying too much graphite to the drawing and allows for a better representation of the brightness in the eyepiece. Then I did a quick check to make sure there were no stars or other details in the galaxy I may have missed. Mark off north and west, and that's it for the sketch. So here's the final image after taking a photo, bringing it into GIMP, inverting, and adding my observation details to the image. I didn't use my focal reducer because for small objects like this, I like to get as much magnification as I can. And too much glass that the light has to pass through can cause the object to appear dimmer than it is. I also didn't use my magnifying eyepiece because I figured this was a good view of the galaxy with a few stars scattered throughout. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to click that like button. If you enjoyed this content and would like to see more, be sure to hit subscribe. And if you'd like to be notified of future videos, click the little bell notification. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. And the constellation Coma... No, and... Canis Venetici?